Hey guys, welcome to another video. Today I'm gonna show you something very special and also very helpful actually. Let's say that you would like to change the color of this accessory over here. And changing the color of it, probably you would have to re-render the image again, right? Or maybe you'd apply a region on this place over here like that. Let me just show you. Right, so like this, you have to like re-render one piece of this object, of course, and paste it on Photoshop to replace the old object. But in this video, I'm going to show you a easiest way to do that, and also much faster than re-render everything or even make a region of this piece of object. Okay, so let's get started. Okay guys, so let's see how to render just this object using the render layers. And this actually feature is quite like the same feature in other renders. They call it render selection. Okay, so how to render a selection object in your render without having to render everything again. Okay, so let's take a look. Firstly, here you have actually to go to the view layer properties, okay, and down here in this Octane render layers setting, you have to turn this on. Okay, so when you turn this on, you can see that nothing happened because you have actually to put an ID to the object that you want to render. So for example, in this case, we are going to render this object. So I'm gonna go to the object properties and then scroll down until you get to the Octane settings and then render layer ID. So here I'm gonna set it to 2 and then I'm gonna go back to my layer properties and I'm gonna change the ID here. So let's put it 2 as well. So as you can see now, we are just rendering only the object that we selected. So this is very helpful and also very powerful because you don't need to render everything again and you are just rendering this piece of object over here. Also, this can save you a lot of time of rendering. Okay, so you're rendering right now just the object that you select, but as you can see, we don't have like any shadows, we don't have also any reflection of this object. And if you take a look in our scene, we have a table that has reflections on it and it's reflecting this gold material of this object. So how we can also render just the reflections of this object and also the shadows of this object? That's what I'm gonna show you right now. So let me turn this to 2 again, number 2. And actually, Octane gives us a very nice passes to use that's called layer shadows, layer black shadows, and layer reflections. So let's take a look on layer reflections first. When you select it, you're gonna see that only the reflections of this object now is activated. Same thing happens actually for the black shadows. And the black shadows actually gives you the shadows in alpha. But to have like this shadows in alpha, actually you have to turn alpha on in the kernel settings. So let's turn the alpha channel on. And now as you can see, we have only the shadows of this object happening in real time here right now. Okay, so let's get back to the passes properties and let's change to the layer shadows. And the layer shadows actually doesn't give you the alpha shadows, the alpha channel. Instead, it gives you a white image with the shadows applied on it. Okay, so this is also very helpful if you don't want to use alpha channel in your projects. So this is also very helpful. So let's change again to combine or if you want to change it to denoise beauty as well, doesn't matter. So as you can see, now we have like this object in alpha as well, because we have we had turned this on in the kernel settings. Okay, all right. So also you can invert the selection. So let's say that you don't want to render only this object and render the everything. You can always like turn off, actually invert and turn on the invert button over here. Now we are rendering everything except for the object that has ID 2. You can also render multiple products. So let's say that you want to render the table as well. So basically what you have to do is change the ID as well. So let's change it to 2, and now we have the table, just this glass part of the table rendering with your object. Okay, so you can render more objects. Let's say that you want to render just this part as well, so you can change the ID or 2 as well. Okay, so that's it, guys. I hope you have enjoyed it, and let me know if you have any questions. I always glad to answer it. Okay, so thank you very much, and see you in the next video.